In part 5, we examine a more complete picture of the exile. According to the Bible, the exile began in Nebuchadnezzar's seventh year, with the deportation of King Jeconiah. This was some 10-11 years before Jerusalem was destroyed, in Nebuchadnezzar's 18th year. Of course, more did go into exile when Jerusalem was destroyed and Judah ceased to exist as a state. However, this deportation could not have left the land totally uninhabited because more people were deported in Nebuchadnezzar's 23rd year. Not everyone went into exile at the same time, nor did everyone return from Babylon at the same time. Both the writer of Matthew and the prophet Ezekiel mark the exile as beginning with the deportation of King Jeconiah, which conventional chronology holds to the year 597 BC. But what does any of this have to do with the 70 years? The 70 years would be a time when the nations would serve Babylon, and would end when Babylon was punished. And this occurred in the year 539 BC. The earliest the exiles could have returned is 538 BC, a year later. Their return would not mark the end of the 70 years. But is there any correlation between the exile and the 70 years? This is why we must examine a letter found in Jeremiah chapter 29, where the prophet addresses those who had been exiled. In this letter, we find Jeremiah's third and final mention of the 70 years. Examining the context of this letter should help us make an accurate assessment of the matter. In the interest of keeping this video short, we will not read this entire passage verse by verse. This is homework for you. Read Jeremiah chapter 29, in particular verses 1 through 14. It might even help if you pause the video if your circumstances allow, and read this chapter before we proceed considering the selected verses. Verses 1 and 2 set the audience and time frame of this letter. And these are the words of the letter that Jeremiah the prophet sent from Jerusalem to the remainder of the exiles, and to the priests, and to the prophets, and to all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had deported from Jerusalem to Babylon, after the going out of Jeconiah the king, and the queen mother, and the court officials, and the leaders of Judah and Jerusalem, and the artisans and the smiths from Jerusalem. In verses 3 through 9, the prophet Jeremiah tells the exiles to settle down, build houses, plant gardens, marry, and have children. Their prosperity would be tied up with Babylon's prosperity, and they were to pray for that nation. He tells them not to listen to the false prophets who were telling them that they were about to return. However, in verse 10, he gave the exiles hope. For thus says Yahweh, as soon as the time has passed, 70 years for Babylon, I will attend to you, and I will fulfill my good word to you, to bring you back to this place. Context means everything. When doing the proper exegesis, we must first ask, who, what, when, where, and why? Who was this letter written to? It was written to the exiles, in particular those who were deported with King Jeconiah. When was this letter written? It was written during the reign of Zedekiah, before the destruction of Jerusalem, and from the flavor of the context, it seems shortly after the exiles arrived in Babylon, in 597 BC. Why was this letter written? False prophets were telling the exiles that they would soon go home. However, Jeremiah tells them to settle down, that they would be there for some time. What was the relation of the exile to the 70 years? Jeremiah was assuring them that after the 70 years for Babylon was concluded, then God would allow the exiles to return. Notice that the 70 years do not end with the return of the Jews, but the 70 years must be fulfilled first. Then they may return. As we've seen from Jeremiah chapter 25, verses 11 and 12, the 70 years would be a time when the nations would serve the Babylonian superpower. And when the 70 years were up, Babylon would be punished. Likewise, at Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 10, when the 70 years were up for Babylon, it would be a signal for the exiles that they would soon be free to return. Those who argue that Jeremiah 29:10 states that the exile would be 70 years at Babylon, rather than the Jews waiting for deliverance at the fulfillment of 70 years for Babylon, miss the context. Even if Jeremiah was telling the Jews that the exile was 70 years at Babylon, keep in mind he was talking to those exiled 11 years before Jerusalem was destroyed. If we would assume for a moment the 607 chronology, these exiles would thus begin their sentence in the year 618 BC. And if we count forward 70 years, we would end up computing the end of the exile in 548 BC, 9 years before Babylon fell. Obviously, this does not compute. Part of the misunderstanding comes from a version of the Bible favored by 607 proponents. This version translates Jeremiah 29:10 as saying 70 years at Babylon. However, most other modern translations say for Babylon. Which is it, at Babylon or for Babylon? Does this verse mean that the exiles would be in the city of Babylon 70 years? The translation and meaning of this verse requires more examination.